not a lot that you've been saying.
Hello! So, this is a film about television. We personally think it's a kind of social media that isn't prioritized in our modern society.
Because most of the things that we watch on television we can now find online. So, in celebration of television, we have chosen to do this film.
Enjoy!
At the moment, my favorite TV shows are Grey's Anatomy.
Okay.
For many years.
Okay.
I love the Danish show Dikte on Mondays. And what else? I think that's the favorite shows at the moment. I watched Top Chef.
No.
Cooking show.
Yeah.
Revenge.
I like Revenge.
Star Trek. Downton Abbey.
What age are you?
14.
14. Beverly Hills.
Yeah, okay.
I think Beverly Hills was that.
Okay, what was it about?
It was about young kids in Beverly Hills, Los Angeles. Yeah. Going to school, having teenage problems. Yeah. It was a big change back then. Because there weren't that many TV shows then compared to now. Mm-hmm. So it was like everyone was watching Beverly Hills.
I liked a feature called Who Won Sophie.
SpongeBob SquarePants. that was a big one. And when I was a teenager, I liked Saved by the Bell.
I would say they're a bit more problem oriented nowadays. It was a bit more just being happy before. Easier life before. I think there are a lot of more TV shows that are more interactive with the audience, and it's all about voting out people nowadays, I would say. And there are a lot more TV shows to choose from. Mm.
And TV series as well, what do you think? Like, not reality series, because but kind of episode.
Yeah.
Series.
Yeah.
Like, what do you think? Is it problem? As well?
Not all of them, no. Okay. No, I don't think so. Yeah. I don't really know if there's such a big difference. I think it's more of the concept reality shows. I would say the others, I don't think there's so much.
Now it's much more commercial. And there are also commercials in the TV shows. That's a break between like five breaks for half an hour or something. And I really don't like that.
Yeah.
Because we live in a commercial society, and that's, you need that in this kind of society, unfortunately, I think.
The quality of the image is a lot better.
Okay.
But that also is a little bit frustrating sometimes, because then you see so many details.
Okay.
So it gets a little bit busy on the screen. And it's a lot faster. If you watch shows from 90s, the story is just a lot slower.
Yeah.
That's what we're used to.
But like, was it the commercials? Were they the same? Or
I don't know for now, because I haven't properly watched television for a couple of years, actually.
Yeah.
I just watch everything on the internet now.
Yeah.
Menu of ad blocker. So.
Big room.
Okay.
Especially here in Sweden.
Yeah.
In the winter part of the year, for like 6 months, I would say a lot of people stay inside.
Because we know how wild so much.
Exactly, and then I mean, if you stay inside, of course, some percentage of the time is watching television every single
day.
I think it's getting smaller. It used to be entertaining and informative, and I think it the last few years it got much more about entertainment.
No, I don't know that.
Okay, it's called
about friends.
Okay. I think it's... could it be... No. No, I don't know the one either.
This one is Pretty Flyers.
Okay.
Yeah, and it's really popular.
First place.
Yes.
I'm old.
No.
Oh, I'm not a new one. I guess it's a kind of a vampire thing, but I don't know.
It's called The Vampire Diaries.
Okay.
And it's what we watch.
That's a trend now, actually. That, compared to before, it's a lot more focused on zombies and vampires, I would think.
Okay. No. I don't know that one either.
It's The Vampire Diaries.
Okay.
Yeah.
I don't know that one either.
Oh.
Zombie.
Zombies.
It's called Walking Dead. This is a little bit scary.
No. Oh, yeah. I know this one.
But I don't remember the name of it.
So no, it's Gossip Girl.
Aha. Orange is the New Black.
Yeah.
I love that one.
Oh, you watched it?
Yeah.
No, I don't know either.
He's doing it. Orange is the New Black.
Aha, okay.
We think it's interesting how TV shows and TV in general has changed and developed through the years. For example, we in the younger generation watch a specific type of TV series, but at the meanwhile the older generation watch another kind of TV series.
That's why we're now going to show trailers of the TV series we watch to two people from the older generation and see how they react. So let us present to you Parents React on TV shows!
But before we start, here's some quick facts about television and its history. So, in the late 1800s, people started research about photoconductivity. It's basically a type of science subject connected to photography and moving pictures. The word television actually comes from the ancient Greek word tele, meaning far, and Latin word visio, meaning sight. John Logie Baird and Paul Gottlieb Nipkow was the most famous scientists in the beginning of the 1900s. These old men were all about moving pictures and scanning discs. We're just gonna leave it like that. Science developed through the years, and during the International Electricity Congress in Paris in August year 1900, the word television was used for the first time. In year 1926, the first moving picture was shown, and it was a work of John Logie Baird. Then it all developed from there. The design of television was improved throughout the years, and then, about 40 years later, in the 1960s, television was one of the most wanted products on the market. So, The Walking Dead is about a cop named Rick that happens to have an accident and then gets to a hospital. When he wakes up from his coma, he's all alone and there's dead people everywhere. While he was asleep, there was a zombie apocalypse. Rick then starts searching for his family with huge determination that they're still alive. While watching the series, you follow Rick's family and friends and their struggle to survive while the world they knew before has gone lost. The series is basically about zombies. So for you zombie lovers out there, we would really recommend it.
Two hours later. Six and a half hours later.
No, I didn't know. It was based on a comic. No. I can't say I got scared or felt uncomfortable, because I have difficulties to relate to this kind of movies or TV series, because I'm more fan of realistic shows, realistic stories. Maybe it's boring, but you know, that's me.
Oh, just a little. When the zombies came, I don't like zombies. I think they are a little yucky. Actually, I would like to watch this series because I heard about it. You are watching it.
Mm. Regarding the last answer, so no, I'm not going to watch this TV series.
If you like gossip, handsome boys, stylish clothes, and drama, then this is a TV show for you. You follow characters that are in their 20s and that live on different sides of Manhattan. While you struggle with knowing Gossip Girl is, Gossip Girl is a new person who knows every little dirty secret about all the characters. You know you love me. XOXO, Gossip Girl.
Kids on the upper side, upper west side, well, New York.
Nothing else?
Not very interesting.
Okay.
For grown-ups. Well, I've heard it. I recognize the name. I don't recognize the logo. So obviously, I mean, it must have been a lot of talk about the series, like Sex in the City or whatever, but no, I never seen it.
I haven't heard anything about Gossip Girl, because I don't read articles about Gossip Girl. Maybe that's why, I think.
the last one.
Can't say recognized or identified or felt anything for one single character in this TV series.
I mean, in one way, it's more interesting to look at on a series that pictures another culture, and I think that the Swedish series are, it's not that professional, the production.
In The Vampire Diaries, you follow the main character, Lena, that loses her both parents and gets to know vampires. Her friends also follow her footsteps and in the end becomes vampires, as well as Lena. You also follow the two Salvatore's brothers, Stefan and Damon, that both are vampires. This series has become popular because of the fine mix between fantasy, reality, drama and romance, but also because of the handsome vampires. If you're into all that, then this is a series for you.
Little girl who lost her parents. I'm gonna start fresh. Be somebody's friend.
Is it Vampire Diaries?
Yeah.
Vampires, and I watched the movie Dracula, and I read the story about him, and this is sort of doing it in our time, but doesn't really, I don't like it that much. Mm-hmm. Yes, I think it's one of your favorites.
Yeah.
And are you watching it as well?
No. I don't like vampires.
No, but it's a very, it's very popular.
Because I'm not, googling. No. I'm not searching for vampire series. No.
Why?
I think I'm too old, and it's obviously for younger people. More realistic and drama-based series. Though I love stories, I love fairy tales, I love like The Lord of the Rings and that kind of films. And but this is a little bit too much. The Walking Dead one was better.
I have already told you that I'm a boring person who prefer drama series. But when I watched this clip, I realized that the American producers are very good at editing the clip, so they can make it more interesting.
I think they are professionally done. And I really liked the first one. I mean, that one could really capture me if I saw one episode.
That is a difficult question. I think I prefer Gossip Girl.
Okay.
Yeah.
Definitely the first one.
I think the American are they are pretty good to produce some series that I like, and I think the British are very good to produce drama series and detective stories and thrillers, and the Danish. I've seen some Danish series lately, but we can't forget the Swedish drama series, like The Bridge or.
Oh, I like the English productions, and of course I love the Danish productions. It's a huge difference. When I was young, I mean, I grew up to Pippi Longstrump and Pojken med guldbyxorna, and now they made a movie of that television series, and it's quite different than it was. It was, you know, I'm 51, it was completely different at that time. There were like two channels and not so many series for younger people.
The TV series of my childhood, that they were more, I think, innocent, not that violent, not that dramatic.
Aren't you lucky?
A summary of the film.
Yeah. We're interviewing people that are older than us. We realize that the series we watch isn't the same series that they watch. Since almost all of the people didn't recognize even 50% of the series they were on the pictures we show them. So maybe there's a gap between our generation and theirs.
And when we dug deeper into the subject, we also noticed that there actually is a huge development from the TV series from the older generation's childhood and ours. We personally think that television, the social media television, has been influenced a lot about because of society. Since society consists more and more of commercials and advertisements, so of course the television takes after. And for example, that one woman we interviewed, she didn't watch TV that much because she couldn't stand all the commercial breaks and advertisements that were everywhere. And an alternative for her would be to watch her series on the internet and therefore avoid much of commercials and advertisements that are on television, like the guy we interviewed did. Because he told us that he hadn't even watched TV in a few years. Oops, kidding. Yeah, yeah. Watch this. It's not a lot that you've been saying, but I can tell from your body. Oh, are we still on?
I don't know. Hello. I mean, but hello.
Hello.
So this is a film about television. We personally think it's a kind of social media that isn't prioritized in our modern society. Fun.
Det är fara.
Hello.
Kör!
Hello!
For example, we in the younger generation watch a specific type of TV series, but at the meanwhile, sluta stå på tå.
This is how we do.
Okay, improvise.
Mamma. Vänta. Jag sitter i mammas kvar.
Igår. Jag sitter i mammas.
Ska
vad vill du?
Hallå.
Blooper 247.
Hello. So, this is a film about television. We personally think it's a kind of social media that isn't prioritized in our modern society.
Society. Hello.
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 Hello. Hello. Hello! So, this is a film about television. We personally think it's a kind of
Nej, jag vet! Vi klarar det! mine, so meh.
So, sorry.